I have spoken to you on Kapalbhati breathing and its benefits. Today in the series of talks on breathing, I will speak on long deep breathing and fire breath. These are interrelated to some extent. For those who have been doing long deep breathing and the breath of fire for many years, breath is so natural and easy that one is also teaching. One might not easily focus on what the difficulty could possibly be. If you are breathing and consuming less air, or breathing very slow, not haphazard, then life is also prolonged. Quite often, when you fill the lower abdominal areas of the lungs, then as you try to fill the chest area, the air is shifted from lower area to the chest. And as you try to lift the rib cage and do not actually keep the downward pressure of the air in filling upward, instead one shifts upward, so that a complete breath is still only chest breathing and not actually diaphragm breathing. There is a difference between chest breathing and diaphragm breathing. The conscious awareness of diaphragm is not apparent to everyone, so many means needs to be provided to somehow allow attention to the sensation of the use of diaphragm to come into focus until the natural rhythm of the diaphragm is felt and the effortless force and flow of prana, the life force, takes over. The lower part of the chest around the rib cage is the diaphragm. Below the diaphragm is the solar plexus region. And in the beginning it becomes difficult because we have not explored the chest region and we have not explored the diaphragm region. Deep long breathing is a way to relax and also very good for all lungs related problems. Taking deep breath. It is said whenever you are doing something, you take a deep long breath. Long deep breathing is usually taught first because one can become aware of the full distension and contraction of the diaphragm, after which the breath of fire may come more naturally. Without deep long breathing or practicing it or knowing it or being fully conscious of it, the fire breath does not become natural. Sitting cross-legged in long deep breathing, one will first fill the abdominal region by inhaling the air down, then pressing the air consciously into the lower areas by arching somewhat forward with one's palms on the knees, then with the arms straight, pressing the palms inward towards the lower body against the knee. The chest cavity will open. Now I repeat this, you are sitting in a cross-legged position and you are taking the deep long breath. What happens? Experiment it. When you do the deep long breathing, sitting in cross legs positions with palms resting on the knees, first the abdominal area is filled as the air is inhaled. Then you are pressing your palms on the knees. As you do this, the arm straightens, and by pressing against palms against the knees, what happens? The arms gets straight and the chest cavity opens, like it is like opening the chest. Pressing this, chest opens up. And when this happens, you can not only keep the pressure on the lungs in lower abdominal area, but also feel the lungs filling in and through the chest area. And finally, because of the forward arch of the spine, the upper area of the lungs will fill as well, the lower part of the lungs and the higher part of. So when you are pressing the palms onto the knees, the arms are straightening, the chest cavity will open forwards, so that now you can not only keep the pressure on the lungs in the lower abdominal area, but also feel the lungs filling in and through the chest area. And finally, because of the forward arch of the spine, because as you are doing this, there is a forward arch of the spine, the upper area of the lungs is filled. And this happens without the need to either open the rib cage or raise the shoulders. You are sitting in the cross legs position, palms resting on the knee. You take the deep long breath. Then you are pressing the palms onto the knees. The arms straighten up. The spine arches somewhat forward. The upper area of the lungs is filled in the process. Once the lungs are completely filled in this manner, hold the breath slightly for a moment and press shoulders back to expand the chest out, so that the full length and pressure on the diaphragm can be felt. Now I repeat these steps once again. Sit in cross legs position, palms resting on the knees. Take a deep long breath, and then you are pressing the palms on the knees, the lower abdomen is pressed. And with that pressure, the air goes up and fills the upper region. The spine forms a forward arch. Once you feel the upper area of the lung is completely filled, then you hold the breath. And as you hold the breath, the shoulders are pressed backward and chest expands. You remain in that position for a little while. This way you will begin to feel the diaphragm. Then contract the entire length of the diaphragm from upper chest to the abdomen, so that the air is squeezed out. By breathing in this way through the nostrils for several breaths, the flow of energy, consciousness, the orgone, the energy particles through the diaphragm can be felt from the pressing down and distending of the air into the lower region of the lungs. By breathing this way, that the process I mentioned, sitting in cross-legged, palms resting on the knees, you take the breath in, filling the lower abdomen, pressing palms on the knees, the arms are straightened, the air moves to the upper area of the chest, then you hold the breath and squeezing out the chest. Before that you feel the diaphragm and then squeezing out the chest, the air is squeezed out. By breathing in this way through the nostrils for several breaths, the flow of energy or consciousness or life force or orgone through diaphragm can be felt from pressing down and distending of the air into the lower region of the lungs where most of the blood circulates, then filling through and up to the chest area from the back to the front into the upper lung. The pressure in the lung in all areas of lungs also generates energy in all the nerve endings, so that the entire body is affected both by the breath and pressure on the nerves. Once deep long breathing is done in this manner, the focus on the muscles of the abdomen, chest and shoulder area as being involved in the breathing begins to recede, as the natural bellows-like motion of the entire diaphragm is felt. This is the process of deep long breathing. Let me repeat this once again. Sit cross-legged, palms resting on the knees. Through the nostrils you are taking a deep long breath, filling the abdominal area. Press the palms on the knees, the arms straighten up, the spine arches somewhat forward, the air moves to the upper part of the lungs, chest area, and as you contract the entire length of the diaphragm from upper chest to the abdomen, the air is squeezed out. When you breathe in this way, the flow of life force or the life energy through the diaphragm can be felt from the pressing down and distending of the air into the lower region of the lungs where most of the blood circulates, and then filling through and up to the chest area from back to the front and into the upper lungs. The pressure in lungs and in all areas of lungs also generates energy. As you are pressing, the pressure in the lungs and all areas, pressure in the lungs in all areas also generates energy. Once you have learned to breathe in this manner, the muscles in the abdomen, chest and shoulder area are being involved in breathing. You can feel the diaphragm, and this deep long breath relaxes an individual. We say take deep long breathing, but what is the process in which the deep long breathing is taken is not explained. We use this word take three long deep breath as a cliche without understanding the process involved in it. When this becomes natural, one can easily go into the breath of fire or Agni Prasanna. It is a cleansing and energizing breath which is powered by abdominal contractions. When we do the process of gyration where the abdominal muscles contract and expand, but it is done not for the breathing but as a demonstration. But if one becomes conscious of that, it can become a tool for the breathing and bringing more life force. Once the diaphragm is felt during the deep long breathing, then there are a couple of ways in which one can begin to do breath of fire, where the air is pulled in and pumped out very rhythmically, just like pumping a bellows, without any tension being felt whatsoever on the abdominal muscle, chest and ribcage muscles or shoulders. All these remain relaxed throughout the breath, so that it may almost seem that you can continue the rhythm indefinitely with little effort at all. It is exactly like contracting the abdominal muscles, which is the part of the gyration. One way to start the breath of fire, which was the way I learned in some many almost 30 years ago, is to start with deep long breathing. Then as soon as the lungs are completely expanded, as described earlier, to immediately force the way out. This is one method. First, the lungs are filled through the deep long breath, as I had mentioned. Then you immediately force the air out. As soon as most of the air is out, immediately expand the air back in, each time arching the spine forward and pressing the palms inward against the knees in a light manner to feel the diaphragm filling the lung from the back to the front completely and then contracting again. With each breath, one expands a little faster and contracts a little faster until without expanding and contracting completely, a rhythm is felt. And you let that rhythm take hold. You might like it to an old model locomotive where wheels lurch forward until some steam and speed is built up. Then suddenly the train is moving forward almost effortlessly, with each breath like the chugging sound of the locomotive. This is the first way. The other way to get into the rhythm of the breath of fire for some may be to immediately go to a forward rhythmic breath, just by visualizing the bellows-like nature of the diaphragm. Either way, from that point on, you can make the breath of fire very powerful and very light. It differs from the other breaths. For instance, Bhastrika. This you can see in the videos of Swami Ramdev by logging this word Bhastrika, which is very simple, and I put this word onto your screen. Bhastrika. This is light, fast, rhythmic breath. Usually it is taught as one of the pranayams in Hatha Yoga process. Fire breath is slightly different. It is used by the Chinese martial art, the people. Also, it is not like the Kapalbhati which I had mentioned earlier. Kapalbhati is a forceful breath where you contract the abdomen and the rib cage, pulling on the root lock with each contracting breath, where simple relaxing of the rib cage brings the air back into the lungs without inhaling, and you force the air out again. But this happens in a rhythmic manner. You are simply exerting the pressure on the rib cage and abdomen to extract the air, and then automatically, as the air is extracted, the fresh air comes in. While Kapalbhati is very powerful and beneficial, and while it is used in many of the Kriya Yogas, there is a difference between action and Kriya. Action, Kriya is the process that when you are doing a certain exercise patterns with certain aim in mind. So it differs from the breath of fire. Breath of fire will entirely charge the nervous system, causing the glands to secrete and purify the blood. This is why the martial artists and then the Kung Fu and all those Chinese arts, the participant takes the breath of fire. It charges the nervous system, causes the glands to secrete and purify the blood. When it is done with certain postures and movements, which are meant to put contracting, that is drawing in or expanding the releasing pressures in the nerve plexus and glandular centers, those areas are made to fire and become completely charged. This is why it is called breath of fire. As an area becomes charged, the sexual or the seminal fluids are released into the bloodstream and flow of those charged areas, so that gradually those areas will maintain that charge, and pranic pressure builds throughout the body, converting all tamasic and rajasic energy. These are the two words of the Trinity: Rajas, Tamas and Sattva. Sattva means the pure. Tamas is referred to as the dark part. Rajas is the blend of the two. And when this happens, the tamasic and the rajasic energy is converted into ojas, which is known as sattvic energy, which fills and permeates the entire body and mind. When breath of fire is done, it will entirely charge the nervous system, causing the glands to secrete and purify the blood. When it is done with certain postures and movements, that is the contracting and expanding pressure in the nerve plexus and the glandular centers, those areas are made to fire and become completely charged. When this happens, and the area becomes charged, sexual or seminal fluids are released into the bloodstream to flow to those charged areas, so that gradually those areas will maintain the charge, and the pressure of the life force builds throughout the body, and this transforms the lower energies into higher or ojas or sattvic energy. The energy is transformed. You transcend the sex. When this process is continued for a long period of time, Then all these negative energies are transformed into ojas or sattvic energy, which fills and permeates the entire body and mind. Bit by bit, over a period of just few weeks of sets and kriyas, the process combining postures, movement and breath, sound and locks, the entire body will begin to feel magnetically electric and etheric. As the field becomes balanced with an inward dynamo-like force, as this charge builds and polarizes, the mind becomes very still, calm, very clear and bright. Radiance is felt in and through and around the body and the head. The feeling of the stressful need to think, the act and to be the doer begin to recede as mind becomes more receptive and open to notice that there seems to be an almost automatic connectedness between one's aims and events and experience that come to fulfill them. The feeling of a natural, ever-present oneness begins to emerge as a clearer, always existing reality. This practice is also helped in Kundalini Yoga with natural awareness and rhythm of the diaphragm in long breathing, and the breath of fire allows the postures and the processes to have the greatest and complete effect in bringing the ojas or the higher energy to the point where self recollects itself and abides without the attention in one's true need. You can try this breathing and see what happens. I have repeated the process a couple times. Listen to these slowly and slowly. Sit in a cross-legged position with palms resting on the knees. Take the deep breath through the nostrils. You will feel the lower abdominal area expanding. When the air is filled, press the knees with the palms. The arms straighten up. As the arms straighten up, the spine takes a forward arch and the air moves to the upper area of the lungs. Then you are straightening the shoulder somewhat. The chest opens up. Now the process of contraction begins. And then this process goes in the rhythm. Then you continue like this, in that all the negative tendencies begin to transform into the more positive tendencies. The ojas or sattvic energy tends to fill and all the other things happen. So what is important to do this breathing and see what actually happens. Many things will happen. If there is any problem again, you can mention it. I will further explain. Because most of us do not know how to breathe properly. We take shallow breaths as if we are afraid of what breathing does. But breath is the essential part for our bodies. So we should drink heavily and deeply to energize and feed our bodies. I will further explain in tomorrow's session some breathing techniques. Only this much for this morning on deep breathing and fire, breath of fire.